Friends, welcome back to Topper's World. In today's video, I'm going to touch very important topic which is very useful for all the IELTS students. That is, how can we do or learn paraphrasing? Paraphrasing is extremely useful in all the modules of IELTS, whether it is writing, reading, listening or speaking. And in this video, I'm going to tell the different methods or techniques of doing paraphrasing. So first of all, let's see what does actually mean by paraphrasing. Simply, paraphrasing means that you have to rewrite a sentence or phrase using different words but having the same meaning. For successful paraphrasing, you need to have a full understanding of the question, and you should have complete understanding of the question, and this is a kind of process which requires expertise or some mental abilities. Basically, there are four methods for doing paraphrasing. The simplest one is synonyms. If you have good command in synonyms, you can use this technique. Second one is changing the word order, means you change the place of words. And third is changing the form of word, like from noun to adjective, adjective to adverb form. And the fourth is active to passive. You can use all these methods individually, separately, or you can have combination of them, or you can use all of them to have a very effective paraphrasing. So let's learn step by step. So first, see an example to understand the effect of synonyms. My car needs petrol. This is present indefinite sentence. And I changed car into vehicle, needs into requires, and petrol into fuels. So in this way, the new sentence will be my vehicle requires fuel. So in order to master this art, you should have knowledge of synonyms. And synonyms can be like, for example, beautiful means very attractive, kind is generous, and people can be like folks or humans. So these are the synonyms that can help you to rewrite the sentence in your own words. Let's take one more example. In the second example, violent crime is on the rise among teenagers. So crime has been changed with offenses, and is with R, and on the rise means increasing. Among young people, teenagers mean young people or youngsters. So sentence will become like that, violent offenses are increasing among young people. Change the order of the words. For example is, learning to manage money is an important aspect of life. So this can be paraphrased like, learning to manage money in life is an important aspect. Or this can also be paraphrased like that, learning how to manage money is one of the most important aspect of human life. In this way, you can add one extra word, or you can delete or omit any word from the given sentence, but the sense will be same. But you have to be very careful while changing the order, because you should be 100% sure that your grammar should not get wrong. You should be sure enough regarding 100% correct use of grammar. Now look at a very simple example. He was very hungry, so he stole food. He stole food because he was very hungry. The order is totally changed. Another very useful way is to do paraphrasing is by changing the form of the word. The form of the word can be changed from noun to adjective, verb, adverb. But one thing you have to keep in mind, that you should be 100% sure regarding the accurate use of grammar. So check the grammar rule first while using this technique. So let's see one example. Look at the example. Sugar price rose dramatically. So dramatically is adverb here. Rose verb, sugar price subject. And there was a dramatic rise. Rose is changed into rise, and dramatically into dramatic. So rise has become a noun. This is a noun here, and this is adjective. So dramatically earlier was adverb changed into adjective and rose verb into noun. So there was a dramatic rise in prices of sugar. In this way, this can be done. This is also one of the easiest method of paraphrasing. And in for effective use of this method, you need to learn how to change active into passive or passive into active. And see in an example. The next method is, so change from active to passive. This is a very simple. You have to change subject into object or object into subject and introduce helping verb and then third form of verb. So let's see one example. Government invested $30 million in the development of education. Government invested. Government is subject here, invested verb, and $30 million object. So object can be brought in front of the sentence, in the beginning of the sentence, as a subject. $30 million was invested in the development of the education. So in this way, there are four methods that I have discussed with you to do paraphrasing. You can use the combination of them, all of them, or any two of them as per your comfort level. And one advice is that you should practice these things and you should make your grammar stronger if you want to try these methods. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.